titty. But the rest of the club hold jacking it up, showing titty. They talk about me when the man in the motherfucker bidding. Better back on up, got the straps on us, 150. This nigga get jiggy. Yeah, nigga, we with it. They see the ice on me, bitch, you come around me, start chilling. This just the beginning. I got niggas timid. No fraud in the coop, but I ball like a hoop, I'm swishing. Ain't got no feelings, just making a killing. Kilo my neck, hey, kilo my wrist, hey, kilo my whip, hey, kilo my dick is full of kilos, my wrist is full of kilos, my job, my paycheck, kilos, I drive my whip with kilos, hey, hey, kilo my neck, hey, kilo my wrist, hey, kilo my whip, hey, kilo my dick is full of kilos, my wrist is full of kilos, my job, my paycheck, kilos, I drive my whip with kilos, hey, hey, what a bitch from Chanel bags. That's 25 racks, yeah. Just to hit it from the back, yeah. Just for bringing that crack here. Nice car, I'm a pastor. Drop change, I'm a cashier. You niggas pussy like a plasma.
All right, I got a little bit more time this morning. I'm gonna try and hit that 355, 3x3. See what that do. Take a scoop of creatine real fast. Baseball. Don't play me like a fool. Gonna burn some shit down. Yeah.
Hey, cubes on my necklace can cool off a drink. Hey, uppercut backwards, that straight to the face. Started with crumbs, fresh out the slums. Pull up in the four with low gas in the tank. You can smell sour when you walking my way. I'm taking selfies inside of the bank. Hey, hey, bitch, I'm in portrait mode. In real life, but look like a portrait though. Flick, pull up in Porsche slow. Then take off like where did them horses go? Hey, ho, I'm in portrait mode. We need a new drip and force me cold. Snap, the picture is perfect. The person that's inside the picture important. So, little bit got mad and asked me to buy her a Birkin. I told her I can't. To give me a business proposal, let's go to the bank. All of my opps going broke trying to flex for the gram, and they know that they can't. Picasso with life is a portrait to paint. Both stars be candle, I'm into the cake. I'm in the foreign, low gas in the tank. Just like a cookout, they got paper plates. Cubes in my earlobes can cool off a drink. Low coming in on the rust on that bows on the way. What's the ticket on that? It's a rape. Singles and jacks and blues and them grass and them tins. If you add it, I take it and change. I bag a ratchet and take her to Spain. Cut off your wrist if your rollie is fake. Hey, slapping hard as a drunk as the father. I leave from the trap, take the count to the bank. I'm rocking Louis with Nene and Gigi with Didi, Givenchy and CC and James. Hey, bitch, I'm in portrait mode. In real life, but look like a portrait though. Flick, pull up in Porsche slow. Then take off like where did them horses go? Hey, ho, I'm in portrait mode. We need a new drip and force me goes.
Ain't lying to you, bitch.
The picture is perfect. The person that's inside the picture important. So, hey, bitch, I'm in portrait mode. Hey, oh, I'm in portrait mode.
Ah, bitch. Fuck all that motherfucking dumb shit. Fuck it. Yeah. Ah.
Back over here at the Grange, and me and the homie Nat are in the 100-yard room. And I got the 16-inch KS47 again, which is the Wolverine. And I also got the hybrid again, which is just called hybrid. So back in here, and now I'm actually shooting at 100 yards. I should have posted the actual targets that I shot, but let me tell you, man, at 100 yards, I was actually surprised on how well both of these guns did. Now, Nate's, he's shooting his AR-15. Now, both mine that I'm shooting are 7.62 by 39. So, different little, you know what I'm saying, different things going on. However, with being in the 100-yard room and actually seeing how far 100 yards is with the naked eye, is it's I don't know, I like it. I like it. So I definitely want to get into some hunting type things, but using this ACOG style scope, looking down range at 100 yards, it's kind of hard. And the main thing that I'm trying to do is put the chevron in the middle of a target. It's not the same, and I'm sure y'all know this, it's not the same when you're looking at something that's 25 yards or even 50 yards where you can actually make out what it is that you're shooting. When it's at 100 yards and your scope is just a four times magnificent magnified scope at four, I think it's like 4x32, I believe. It gets a little difficult, and I haven't done any adjustments to any of the scopes, at least at this time, to make it a better, make better groups than what I would like it to be. Because on this day, I only had, an hour and a half, 2 hours, I think 2 hours to no, it was less than that. I think about an hour and a half in order. Yeah, see, look, you see that right there? That's an 100 yards. That is nice. That is nice, at least for me, because I'm not a long range shooter yet. But to me, I'm thinking that's a win. Now, Like I said, I didn't have a lot of time to shoot because this day, my wife and I were going to get our first vaccine shot. And we're not about trying to miss the appointment. And I ain't trying to piss my wife off neither, but I'm out here doing fun shit for myself. And she got both of the girls at home on a Saturday morning. So granted, I'm going to try and do what I can within the small amount of time that I have, but the KS-47 still has a hard kick, but shooting it more, I'm getting used to the recoil and way that it feels, and being able to aim at something long range. So I will keep on shooting this gun. I will figure out how to get it more precise as it is. Got two things on here I still got to sight in. I got to sight in the ACOG style scope, and I got to sight in that RMR. So when that gets done, this is going to be something that I would like to do a little couple competitions with. Just probably starting off with the friendly competitions with friends and whatnot, but we'll, I'm trying to make something happen here with the gun community. You know what I'm saying? Put some money on the line, you know, $5 here, $10 there, you know what I'm saying? Tightest groups, shoot the best group in the center mass within a certain amount of time, stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? Stuff that's fun. This is Nate's first time shooting the KS-47, and he does agree with me. It's a heavy trigger. It's a strong gun. It still has the AR-15 feel to it, but that trigger is something else. And unfortunately, you can't change out the trigger as easy as you could an AR-15 or an AK-47 because of the mag release. That's proprietary. And the way that mag release is, I can't get a CMC in there. Now, I might be able to get, I'll have to look up what Palmetto says. I might be able to get an ALG in there, might be able to get a Geiss in there. Between you and me, I ain't about to spend the money to put a Geisley in this. Not trying to shame the gun, but I have other things I'd rather put a Geisley into. But we're not there yet. One other thing I would like to kind of be upset about is I bought some charging handles, some Raptor charging handles. Let me not say Raptor. I have a Raptor charging handle, but by Radian, but it's some off brands, and it did not fit. And it's because, and I know it's because it's off brand, and I should have spent the extra money to put it in there, but I'm mad that I wasted that money. All right, hybrids on deck. Nate likes hybrid because of the ambidextrous safety, being able to put the charging handle on each side, and man, just look at that recoil. It's at 16 inches. It's great for me, at least. Better than Wolverine. Later I'm gonna get the 12-inch, I think it's a 12 or 12 and a half inch hybrid M10X, which I call Skeletor. And I got some plans on Skeletor, but the difference between the recoil on that and the recoil on this, night and day. Check it out. Second time shooting Bane. Let me see if I can get through a whole mag. Hey, that's success. This is the second time I took Bane out. First time was last year. So it's been a very long time since I took Bane out, and it went through the whole mag no problem doing it on binary. Definitely happy about that. All right, Gen 5, first time shooting Gen 5 ever, and ALG triggering this, let it rip. ALG trigger on that. Pfft, homie. Woo. Man. I got some other things cooking up. All right, so we made up this little competition. Two mags and five rounds, but your partner loads the mags, tap on the shoulder, and try to hit center mass. I do not have Nate's video, but let me tell you, he messed up real bad. Like, real bad. Like, he almost gave up. I was like, I gotta keep going. All right. Second round. Oh, and I'm gonna tell you. Hold on. All right. My shots were not center mass. They should have been, but they weren't. Oh, hit me up. Here I am with hybrid, and I really messed up on hybrid. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and say it. He beat me on those, but we'll come back to these games, and I'm gonna win.
Hey, I'm at the vault, like I said I was gonna be. Deadlifts on deck, back is on deck. Got my first vaccine. I have no side effects, so I'm good. My arm's not sore. My wife said her arm is sore, but it's possible because I have more muscle than she does. The motherfucking doctor said I was ripped. I know, he said I was jacked. I'm like, hey, I might get another shot just so I can hear somebody say that shit again. You know what I'm saying? But I think I had a slight headache earlier. I went to sleep, woke up, it was gone. As of now, though, I'm going to start off on the reverse hyper to get this lower back activated. I'm not really going to go for anything nuts. I basically want to hit 5 plates, and it'll be cool to hit that for 5 reps. And definitely want to hit core. Still want to hit this GHR. After deadlifts, I do want to superset everything with biceps. So depending on how I feel, I'll try and do some dumbbell rows. And so something for the lats, actually. So I'm gonna think about it while I'm in the zone, but I'm gonna get started right now. Yeah.
Thank you. Right at 7 in the morning, but like, daddy, what's the daggum deal? That's time for shenanigans. That 505 was hard as fuck, man. I don't know if it was because of how late it is or just any effects from the shot, but that shit was hard. I'm glad I got that shit, though. I got what I said, 5 reps. Just gotta do more work. There's no excuses on that weak shit, though. It's all about the damn work, the sets, the reps, the shit that you do in between. That's what I'm gonna have to keep fucking with. I'm gonna clean all this shit up, and I'm gonna get in the truck. I'm gonna get to the house. Avoid the felony. Don't talk to cops. Yeah.
Hey. 4:52 a.m. and I'm here right now. 30 minutes of cardio completed and squats is on deck. I'm gonna put the Buffalo bar back on the rack and get some sets with that on there, and I possibly will get this shit done and later on hit bench with the intention to do that at lunchtime either do that at lunchtime or do that after I get back from taking the baby girl to school, depending on how this goes. And I want to go to the vault, get some accessories done. But man, I plan to try and work all day today. So whether it be right now, then after I come back from taking the girl to school, and then lunchtime, and then after work. If that's possible, then damn it, I want that to happen. So fuck all this talking shit, let's make this move shit happen. Yeah.
Hey, where you get that beat from?
Mucho!
Okay, I got that guapo. I pull up like I'm eating El Chapo. I pull off with a trunk full of cargo. I put guns in the hands of my vatos. I keep clipped up or down with them hollow. I keep something out the beef out your taco. I know they mix the fit with the Rallo. I told Chi get the yayo and vamos. Okay, wake up, go get me some money. Look how I look, don't I dress like I run it? Stunt like a stunner, man, you be astonished. Hit from the back, bitch, a snatch off a bunny. Shit on your bucket list, already done it. Run through the package, another one coming. Nut on the back and then nut on the stomach. Nut on the covers, I damn wear a rubber. Damn, okay, taste it for pretext. I don't care how many it is, cut a V-neck. Better oil between my thumb and my index. Okay, bust it and ship it, them three necks. Damn, it's locked on my shirt, that's a reflex. Keep a house full of gangsters and rejects. Time to catch us a goofy with remix. I can't give you this game, it's a secret. Mix it and shift it and taste it. Perfectly bend it, that shit, don't you waste it. Fuck out the kitchen, don't play by the table. I'm watching cameras, not watching no cable. A sign on the wall say I can't do no favors. Baggies and clocks and some glocks and some razors. Sticks with extensions and clips and some traces. Pencil you in, let my youngins erase you. Okay, I got that guapo. I pull up like I'm eating El Chapo. I pull off with a trunk full of cargo. I put guns in the hands of my vatos. I keep clipped up or down with them hollow. I keep something out the beef out your taco. I know they mix the fit with the Rallo. I told Chi get the yayo and vamos. Okay, wake up, go get me some money. Look how I look, don't I dress like I run it? Stunt like a stunner, man, you be astonished. Hit from the back, bitch.
Hey, alright. Before I get started with the recap, let me tell you what just happened, which I have realized is something I'm about to be more aware of. I'm just now leaving the gas station. It's 6:12 a.m. and I put gas in my wife's truck and I changed out the car seats. I rearranged them. Let's not say change them out. My wife wanted them changed, so I did that change at the gas station. The gas station that I go to, they have those gas pumps where it plays advertisements on a little TV, and it plays the shit really fucking loud where you can't hear anything else around you. But I'm doing all this rearranging car seat shit, this homeless guy walks up on me, you know what I'm saying, and thank God old dude yelled out, hey, real loud before he got too close. But he walked up on me and my first reaction is, all right, hold on, let me see what he got. So in one arm, he's holding all his clothes. The other arm, other hand, he has a lighter. And I'm like, I'm really looking. I'm like, is that a lighter? Is that a knife? And I'm also thinking, all right, let me keep a little distance between dude, because if I got to pull out this pistol, I might have to bust on it. I ain't going to try, you know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to just say back up. I'm more like, look, if I gotta pull this out on you, bro, it's gonna be it. And he started talking about mental health. Well, you know, mental health, and I was really waiting for him to ask a question. And first of all, I think his question was, can I ride him somewhere? And I'm like, nah, man, I'm busy, I gotta do shit for the wife. He's like, all right, do you got something that I can eat? And I actually did. So I gave him some food out the car, out the truck. Then he asked what road was he on. I told him where he was at. and he went north where he would go. And he was like, cool, gave me a fist bump and walked off. And I thought to myself, man, this loud ass gas station TV is a problem, because for him to be able to walk up on me like that, where I feel like I still would have seen him on the peripheral, but by the time I would have saw him, it may have been too late, or I would have had to panic and pull out the pistol when I possibly may not have need to. But I'm going to be more aware of that in the future. Squats 325, 3x5, pretty daggum good. As I got later in the sets, shit started feeling a lot easier. The first set, that 325 felt heavy, but as I kept going, it got a lot easier for me. Superset everything with bicep curls and calf raises with the chains. I can actually notice my calves looking bigger in the... I can notice my calves looking bigger in these socks that I'm wearing. So I'm definitely gonna keep doing that. I think I do got a lot of gas left in me, so I'm gonna try and get the bench press knocked out when I get back from taking Rebecca to school. I'm gonna get back with you. Void the felony. You know the damn deal. Yeah. Hey, we're gonna get this bench press shit going. There's less time, so I got a little bit of an hour to get this. And I'm gonna use the Buffalo bar as I did with the squats. And 325, 3x5. That's what I did. That's what I've been doing with the 315. So we're gonna do the 325, 3x5. And I wanna see the same results. Let's move your shit right now. Yeah.
We are building something spectacular. I'm getting stronger.
The strength is just coming natural. It's gonna do that. You see squared, no sense hat. Shit. Ain't no problem with the sense thing, it's too big.
Just like that. Done the lunch pump. 325, 3x5. Ooh, that's the PR using that bow bar. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to go check the mail, but that's two sessions out the day.
Like, look what we gotta
do. We
just gotta get
Rosa, to thank you for your
just gotta get to wreck.
Yeah. I wanna win the game. I had a third session at the vault. Fucking up these legs. Hot damn it, I forgot my keys to check the mailbox. Some bitch. Well, anyway. We'll get back with it. I'll get back with it. Fuck that weed shit. I'ma holler at you. I'm going to come. Yeah.
Hey, let me tell you what's going on right here. So, my brother-in-law came into town, and when he comes into town, we like to shoot the guns. So I got, I got G5, which is what I'm having a problem with right here, and I got Warlock, and then I got the brand new Skeletor, which I'm picking up right now, picking up in this video. Well, here's the shit. So, I got swindled on an auction on 1,000 rounds. The guy that sold the shit said he had 900 rounds brand new in the box and then 100 rounds in the bag. Now, I loaded the 100 rounds in the bag not knowing that those 100 rounds were actually reloads. And it didn't work in the G5. It works in this one, though. So it's a little weird, so that those bad reloaded rounds worked in Warlock, but didn't work in the G5. And I actually hold G5 to a higher standard than Warlock, because Warlock is a PSA G3, Generation 3 AK, and G5 is a PSA Generation 5 AK. So I would feel that it would shoot everything, but no, it does not like those motherfucking reload rounds, and I had to learn that, and this, because this is my first time shooting reloads, and I didn't actually know if they're reloads until somebody at the range officer told me. He's like, those are reloads, and they look kind of shitty, and it makes sense that the motherfucker would sell the shit in a bag, not in the box. Because I thought, I made up reasons on why the shit was in the bag, thinking that, well, maybe he was loading them up in the mags and then he changed his mind. But it's weird to me that Warlock was able to shoot it kind of fine, to at least from what I thought. But man, you know, I had 100 rounds of that shit, so I ended up having to load up the rest of the 100 rounds to get rid of all that, because I don't want to deal with the situation where I'm going to need to play defense and I'm dealing with the motherfucking reloads. Like, here's Skeletor for the first time. Same fucking thing. Skeletor don't like that shit neither. Now, I haven't played around with the gas settings because that's an M10X pistol. I already have an M10X rifle, and I'm trying to think. Okay, well, is Skeletor acting that way because it hasn't been broken in, or is Skeletor acting that way because it's the bad rounds? I'll end up to find out that it's the bad rounds, because on another video, I'm getting rid of all those bad rounds, and I brought Blondie, which is another GF3 AK from PSA, and it wasn't having a good time shooting those motherfucking bad rounds neither. I also got Olive Oil with me, and thing that I ended up having to learn kind of just by trial and error is that the Magpul mags do not necessarily feed well or sit well in the AKVs. Now, I'm about to say AKPs, but in the AKVs, they don't really sit that well. The other ones do, the Scorpions, the Palmetto ones, and the ETS mags do. Something that you need to know. I would like to figure that shit out, because I don't want to be in another situation, like I said, with having bad rounds. I don't want to have bad mags where I'm playing defense and these mags ain't going in. Once these mags are inside, they work. But trying to do a reload, if I'm going to do some competition, which I'm planning on doing something like that probably soon, run and gun, or like I said, somebody breaking into the house or doing something to somebody and I need to stop and be getting into a dadgum shootout and I need another mag. I don't want to fuck around with trying to slam this shit in there. Now, the mags work in all the other dadgum platforms. I got two Scorpions and I got an ARV and they work. So I ain't got to sell them, but I want these motherfuckers to work. So I'm going to do some more research on them and see what's going on. I'm going to brother-in-law fuck with Warlock real fast. Let's slow it down so you can see these wonderful, wonderful muzzle flashes coming out of the crank. So I added the Strike Industries short angled foregrip. That's what he's holding on to. And I think that's a good look for Warlock. And I'm gonna make Warlock a little bit more controllable because as you can see why I slowed it down, look at the muzzle rise from this crank break. So, I mean, it looks sexy, but it's not practical. So, I ordered a break from J-Mac that I have, as of talking to you today, have already put on it, but I haven't shot it yet. So, when you see a video of Warlock, next time I go out, you'll see how that new break from J-Mac is gonna work and should keep that muzzle down, should keep that flash probably not as exciting as you're seeing here, but still a motherfucker nonetheless. But yeah, Warlock is currently right here eating all those bad fucking rounds. This old dude, range officer, let us know that it's time to go because yeah, we came to the gun range super fucking late. I'm talking to the range officer right here about the rounds, and that's when he's actually telling me that these are bad rounds. You got some reloads and there's some bullshit rounds, and that let me know that I just need to dump all this shit out as much as I can, which I will do that in the next video, and you'll be able to see that shit and say whatever it is that you got to say about it.